Hello learners, you are welcome to our English class. And previously we discussed the past or the simple past tense. And then we grouped the verbs into two. That is, we looked at regular verbs and irregular verbs. And then we said with regular verbs, we only add ed to them in their past tense. And then with irregular verbs, their past tense changed totally from the original word. And then we looked at quite some number of examples. Today we are going to look at the present perfect tense, which means we are still on the action verbs. Present perfect tense. Don't forget, before we started our tenses, I told you that the time at which an action was performed tells how we should express it. So the time really matters when we are constructing our sentences using action verbs. So today that we are discussing present perfect tense, we say it is a tense that is used to express actions that were completed in the present time. So meaning that an action was completed, but it was completed in the present time. And when I see the present time, it means that the action happened not long ago, not too long ago. It is formed by using has or have. And then we add the past participle form of the verb. Has, have, and then we add the past participle form of the verb. Meaning that whenever you use has or have, your next action word should be in the past participle form. Now let's look at the difference between has and have. Has is a singular verb, and then have is a plural verb. And it means that whenever our subject is singular, you go in for has. When your subject is plural, you go in for have. Let's look at some examples here. We said he has taken the chair. He has taken the chair. So here, because we say he, being a singular subject, we go in for has. And the moment you bring has, your immediate verb should be in the past participle form. So take as an action word will be taken in the past participle. Taking. So this kind of sentence is a present perfect one because of the use of has and the past participle form of the action word. Example 2. We have broken the plates. We have broken the plates. So here, because the subject is plural, we, so we go in for the plural verb, that is have. Then because we are constructed in the present perfect, our immediate action word should be in the past participle form. So we say we have broken. So break, broke, broken as the past participle form of break. I have worn a new dress. I have worn a new dress. One may ask, why I, and then I is singular and we have used a plural verb. Now I is an exception. So we call it an exceptional rule when we look at the subject verb agreement. It is singular, but it always takes a plural verb. So I have worn, which is the past participle form of the verb wear, worn. So it becomes I have worn a new dress. So these sentences that I've constructed here are examples of present perfect tense. The use of has or have, and then the past participle form of the verb. In our previous lessons, as in the past tense, we looked at some number of examples. So in the notes that I'm going to give you, I'm going to add the past participle form of the verbs. Then you write them in your notes and then you study them. You need to study them. Let's look at only five examples here. We have write. So the past tense of write is wrote, as we discussed in the past tense. Then if you want to construct in the present perfect tense, it means you need to use the past participle form of write, and that is written. So it becomes I have written. Take becomes took in the past, and then taking in the past participle. Break, broke in the past, broken in the past participle. Wear, wore, worn in the past participle. And then with regular verbs, it is very simple. We only add ed to them in the past and in the past participle. So example is call. The past becomes called. The past participle becomes called, the same called. So with regular verbs, we only add ed to them, both in the past tense and then in the past participle form. So I'm going to give you notes. I'm going to give you quite a number of examples of verbs and then their past participle form. Make sure you study, write them in your exercise or notebooks, and then you study them. I'll give you exercise to answer below this particular lesson. See you in our next lessons. Bye.